Namaste children, let us discuss second lesson in 9th class social studies of the natural beings of the earth. In this lesson, let me discuss work of sea waves. Due to work of sea waves, coastal lands are formed, beaches are formed, sea arches are formed, hollow-like cavities formed. Sea arches are formed, stacks are formed, sea cliffs are formed, cape and bay are formed. Children, due to work of sea waves, coastal lands are formed, beaches are formed, hollow-like caves are formed, sea arches are formed, stacks are formed, sea cliffs are formed, cape and bay are formed. Let me explain one by one. How coastal lands are formed? The erosion by sea waves and deposition by sea waves. Coastal lands are formed. Once again, how coastal lands are formed? The erosion by sea waves and deposition by sea waves. As a result, coastal lands are formed. Now discuss how hollow-like cavities form. How hollow-like caves are formed. When the sea waves strikes on the rocks continuously, the rock gets cracked. And the cracks will develop on the rocks. Again, the sea waves strike continuously. Now, the cavities become bigger and bigger and forms like a hollow like caves. See the figure, children, from the textbook, you'll understand very much better. Again, I'll repeat once again how hollow like caves are formed. Once again, children, when the sea waves continuously strike on the rock, cracks develop on the rocks. Again, the sea waves continuously strike on the rocks. Then cavities become bigger and bigger. At last, hollow-like caves are formed, as you see the picture from the textbook now. Again, when the sea waves continuously strike on the hollow-like caves, then sea arches are formed. Once again, children, how sea arches are formed? When the sea waves continuously strike on hollow-like caves, then sea arches are formed. Now again, when the sea waves continuously strike on sea arches, the roof of the sea arches break off. The roof of the sea arches will break off. At last the walls are left. Then they are called stacks. Once again, children, we discuss how stacks are formed. When the sea waves strikes continuously on the sea arches, the roof of the sea arches will break off. At last the walls will remain. The walls will be left. These walls are called stacks. Now discuss what you mean by sea cliff. What you see in this picture for the textbook, this picture is nothing but sea cliff. What is sea cliff? The steep rock rises almost vertically above the sea level. It's called sea cliff. And next we're going to discuss about cape and bay. What is meant by cape? It's a headland cutting out into sea. is the headland cutting out into sea. That means nothing but a part of the land surrounded by water. A part of the land surrounded by water is called cape. What is meant by bay? Wide mouth recess on the line of the coast. What is meant by bay? Wide mouth recess on the line of the coast. That is nothing but a part of water body surrounded by land. A part of the water body surrounded by the land. Let me show this cape and bay from the map. Children, look at the map now. You can see, it's a part of a land surrounded by water. It's a part of a land surrounded by water. This is called cape. If you take India also, see, this is India. It's a part of land surrounded by water. It is called cape. In other words, cape is nothing but the headland cutting out into sea. It's a headland cutting out into sea, or a part of the land surrounded by water. What is bay? What is bay? It's a wide mouth recess on the line of the coast. It's a wide line recess on the outline of the coast. What is bay? It's a wide mouth recess on the line of the coast. That is a part of water body surrounded by land. A part of water body surrounded by land. See in this example now, Bay of Hudson. This is a bay. A part of water body surrounded by land. Once again, we'll teach from a blackboard now. What is a cape? A part of the land surrounded by water is called cape. What is meant by bay? A part of the water body surrounded by land is called bay. At last, come to know about the beaches. How beaches are formed? When the sea waves deposit sediments on the seashore. When the sea waves deposit the sediments on the seashore, thus beaches are formed. The famous beaches in India are Goa Beach, Marina Beach, Ramakrishna Beach, Kodur Beach, Maipada Beach, Mumbai Beach, etc. Now, so far we discussed about the work of a sea waves. Work of sea waves. Due to work of sea waves, coastal lands are formed, beaches are formed, hollow lake areas are formed, sea arches are formed, stacks are formed, sea cliffs are formed, cape and bay are formed. Now, let us discuss about the work of a river. Here in this session, we are not discussing about the work of a river. In this session, let me revise about the work of a river. Here, when you discuss about the work of a river, you should know the journey of a river from starting point to ending point. When you know the journey of the river from starting point to ending point, this river creates different types of landforms like V-shaped valley, gorges, canyons, deltas, meanders, floodplains, oxbow lakes, and waterfall. Let me revise all this concept in briefly. How V-shaped valley is formed? When the river flows a steep valley, and the river at that time, river flows at high speed. When the river flows at high speed in steep valley, mountains are cut down vertically. The mountains are cut down vertically, thus V-shaped valleys are formed. Now discuss about gorges. Before discussing gorges, you should know about V-shaped valley. The width of the valley at the top is wider than at the bottom. Now gorges. As rocks are very hard, the river cuts narrow valley. As the rocks are very hard, the river cuts narrow valley, and thus steep sides are formed. The steep sides are formed. At last, this by that steep sides are formed, by that gorges are formed. In Andhra Pradesh, we have bison gorges across Godavari River. The Indus gorges located in Jammu and Kashmir state. Once again, what is gorges, Amma? Nothing but as when rocks are harder, the river, when the rocks are harder, the river cuts narrow valley, and thus steep sides are formed by the gorges are formed. Now canyons. Canyons are characterized by steep like side slopes. They are deeper as gorges. The width of the canyon at the top is wider than at the bottom. The width of the gorges is equal at the top as well as bottom. The waterfall, yeah, we can find number of waterfall in the mountain. The waterfall from the mountain at high force with greater force on the land forms plunging pool. Now discuss flood plain. When the flood occurs on the river flows at high speed. At that time, the river carries heavy particles from the river bed, that is from inside the river, and deposits with the plain, deposits the flood plain on the bank of the river, and thus the plain becomes a fertile flood plains. As sediments are more in the river, inside the river, as sediments are more or higher in the river bed, the river takes new course, the river changes the course and flows a new path when flood arises. This river forms shelf meanders. What is meander? The river flow like a snake in a floodplain is called meanders. As deposits are there in the sides of meander, the loops of the meander become large and become closer. As the deposits are formed at the sides of meander, then the meander becomes large. The meander of the loop of the meander becomes large and becomes closer and closer. In due course, the meander loop cuts off from the river. The meander loop cuts off from the river and forms a lake. This lake is called Oxbow Lakes. Before the river reaches the sea, it deposits fine particles at the mouth of the river. Mouth of the river means the place where the river joins at the sea. There the river deposits fine particles in a triangle shape called delta. Children, in this session, we discussed about work of seabeds and also we discussed about work of river. In next session, we are going to discuss about work of wind. Work of wind. How biosphere impact ecosphere. Okay, you see these videos repeatedly by keeping the textbook in front of you and related images by seeing Google. If not, we will discuss this lesson very clearly in the discussion classes, and there we identify our doubts. Thank you, children.